Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about auxins. History of auxin. Charles Darwin was among the first scientists to dabble in plant hormone research. In his book The Power of Movement, he mentioned about a plant hormone presented in the year 1980. The term auxin was derived from the Greek word meaning to increase or to grow. This was the first group of plant hormone discovered. Now this is the structure of auxins. One is native auxin, another one is a synthetic auxin. In native auxin, examples are indole-3-acetic acid, which is also called as IAA, indole-3-butyric acid, which is also called as IBA, 4-chloroindole-3-acetic acid, 2-phenylacetic acid, which is also called as PAA. In case of synthetic auxin, example are 2,4-D, full form is 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, alpha-naphthalene-acetic acid, 2-methoxy-3,6-dichlorobenzoic acid, 4-amino-3,5,6-trichloropicolinic acid. So these are some of the examples and structure of the auxin. Biosynthesis of auxin. There are two pathways in biosynthesis of auxin. One is tryptophan dependent pathway, another one is tryptophan independent pathway. In case of tryptophan dependent pathway, it is further divided into four types. One is IPA pathway, TAM pathway or TAM pathway, or another one is IAN pathway and bacterial pathway. Tryptophan dependent pathway. In 1935, Thiemann demonstrated that the fungus Rhizopus sinus could convert amino acid tryptophan into indole-3-acetic acid. Since then, it is generally held that tryptophan is primary precursor of indole-acetic acid in plant. The indole-3-acetic acid can be formed from tryptophan by different pathways. Now this picture represents tryptophan dependent pathway of indole-3-acetic acid biosynthesis in plant and bacteria. So first, the tryptophan is converted into indole-3-pyruvic acid with the help of an enzyme, tryptophan transaminase. Now this indole-3-pyruvic acid is converted into indole-3-acetaldehyde with the help of an enzyme, indole-3-pyruvic acid decarboxylase. Now the enzyme indole-3-acetaldehyde then convert this indole-3-acetaldehyde into indole-3-acetic acid. This pathway is called as IPA pathway because the first intermediate formed by this process is indole-3-pyruvic acid, and this pathway is seen in most of the plants. Now this tryptophan could be converted into indole-3-acetaldoxime with the in case of Brassica, Poaceae and Musaceae, the tryptophan is converted into indole-3-acetaldoxime. Now this indole-3-acetaldoxime will be converted into indole-3-acetonitrile, and then with the help of an enzyme nitrilase, indole-3-acetonitrile is converted into indole-3-acetic acid. So this pathway is called as IAN pathway because the intermediate is the first intermediate which is produced from the tryptophan is indole-3-acetaldoxime. This pathway is seen in Brassica, Poaceae and Musaceae. Next is tryptophan could be converted into indole-3-acetamide in case of bacteria, certain bacteria like Agrobacterium tumefaciens and Pseudomonas species. tryptophan is converted into indole 3 acetamide with an help of an enzyme tryptophan monooxygenase. Later, this indole 3 acetamide is converted into indole 3 acetic acid with the help of an enzyme indole 3 acetamide hydrolase. Then there will be another pathway where the tryptophan is converted into tryptamine with the help of an enzyme tryptophan decarboxylase. Now the enzyme amine oxidase convert this tryptamine into indole 3 acetaldehyde and then to indole 3 acetic acid. So this this pathway is called as TAM pathway, or the intermediate, first intermediate formed from the tryptophan is tryptamine. So this pathway is called as TAM pathway. Tryptophan independent pathway. In recent years, experimental evidence for the existence of tryptophan independent pathway of indole acetic acid biosynthesis in higher plant have been obtained from the mutant of maize and Arabidopsis, which comes under Brassicaceae family. The branch point for the biosynthesis of indole acetic acid, indole 3 acetic acid, may either be indole or indole 3 glycerol phosphate with IAN and IPA as possible intermediate. However, neither the intermediate precursor of IAA in this pathway has yet been identified, nor relative importance of the tryptophan dependent and independent pathway is clearly understood. Mechanism of action of auxin. Auxin cause wide range of physiological effect in plant. Some of these effects, such as cell elongation in shoot, occur in minute in response to auxin, while others such as obsession occur in days in response to auxin treatment. Most studies on auxin induced growth in plant have been carried out in excised section of dicot stem, such as soybean hypocotyl and pea hepicotyl, and coleoptile such as oat and maize coleoptile. But in recent years, auxin induced growth has also been demonstrated in intact auxin deficient mutant of pea. The target site of auxin action in dicot stem are the outer tissue, including epidermis and outer cortex. In coleoptile, all non-vascular tissue, that is epidermis and mesophyll, are responsive to auxin treatment. Auxin signal transduction pathway. So in the absence of auxin, the transcription factor ARF forms the inactive heterodimer with AUX or IAA protein. Now the inactive heterodimer blocks the transcription of early auxin gene. There is no auxin response. Later, auxin signal transduction pathway takes place where in the presence of the auxin, AUX and IAA protein are targeted for the destruction by an activated ubiquitin ligase. Now AUX or IAA protein are tagged with the ubiquitin and degraded by 26S protease. Later, the IAA induced degradation of the AUX or IAA protein, a low active ARF homodimer, to form. Then the active AFR homodimer binds to the palindromic AUXRE in the promoter of the early gene, activating transcription. The transcription of early gene initiate auxin response. Then the auxin mediated growth and development, the stimulation of AUX and IAA gene introduce a negative feedback loop. Physiological effect of auxin. Following points are the highlights of physiological effect of auxin in plant. One is cell elongation, apical dormancy, root initiation, prevention of abscession, parthenocarpy, respiration, callus formation, and vascular differentiation. Cell elongation. The primary physiological effect of auxin in plant is to stimulate elongation of cell in shoot. Very common example of this can be observed in phototrophic curvature, where the unilateral light unequally distribute the auxin in the stem tip. More auxin on shaded side that on illuminated side. Many theories have been proposed to explain the mechanism of cell elongation properly. By reducing the wall pressure, by increasing the permeability of cells to water, by increasing the wall synthesis, and by inducing the synthesis of RNA and protein, which turn led to an increase in cell wall plasticity and extension. Apical dominance. Apical or terminal bud of many vascular plants are very active while lateral bud remain inactive. Removal of apical bud promote lateral buds to grow. Apical dominance is due to much higher auxin content in apical bud than lateral buds. Skoog and Thiemann first pointed out that the apical dominance might be under the control of auxin produced at the terminal bud and which is transported downward through stem to the root. Lateral bud and hinders their growth. They removed the apical bud of the broad bean plant and replaced with agar block. This result in rapid growth of lateral bud. But when they replace the apical bud with agar block containing auxin, lateral bud remained suppressed and did not grow. It is now generally held that inhibitory effect of auxin from shoot apex on the lateral bud is not direct but indirectly possible through the involvement of other growth hormones such as cytokinins and abscisic acid. Root initiation. In contrast to stem, the higher concentration inhibits the elongation of root, but the number of lateral branch root is considerably increased. That is, the higher concentration of auxin initiate more lateral branch roots. Application of IAA in linolin paste to cut end of young stem result in an early and extensive rooting. In fact, this fact is of great practical importance and has been widely utilized to promote root formation in economically useful plant which are propagated by cutting. Prevention of abscession. Natural auxin have controlling influence on abscession of the leaves and fruits, etc. Auxin promote fruit development. Regulation of fruit development after fruit set, fruit growth depends on auxin. Now in this picture, the strawberry fruit is actually a swollen receptacle whose growth is regulated by auxin produced by the seed, which is actually achene, the true fruit. When the achene are removed, the receptacle failed to develop normally. Spraying the achene less receptacle with IAA restore normal growth and development. Parthenocarpy. Auxin can induce the formation of parthenogenic parthenocarpic fruit. In nature also, this phenomenon is not uncommon, and in such case the concentration of auxin in the ovary has been found to be higher than in the ovaries of plant which produce fruits only after fertilization. In the latter case, the concentration of auxin in ovaries increases after pollination and fertilization. Respiration. It has been established that the auxin stimulate respiration, and there is a correlation between auxin induced growth and an increased respiration rate. According to Friends and Beaver, in 1953, the auxin may increase the rate of respiration indirectly through increased supply of ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, by rapid utilization of ATP in the expanding cells. Callus formation. Besides cell elongation, auxin may also be active in cell division. In fact, many tissue cultures where the callus growth is quite normal, continued growth of such callus takes place only after the addition of auxin. Vascular difference. The auxin induced vascular differentiation in plant. This has also been confirmed in tissue culture experiment and from studies of transgenic plants. Cytokinins are also known to participate in differentiation of vascular tissue, and it is believed that the vascular differentiation in plant is probably under the control of both auxins and cytokinins. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.